हाय अक्षय। अक्षय सर, ये यार नॉर्थ आई
हेलो मैम,
आई माइट गेट अ कॉल इन बिटवीन, सो अंटिल देन आई कैन एक्सप्लेन एंड देन यू हैव टू मेक मी द होस्ट अगेन प्रोबेबली। ओके, सो टुडे वी विल लर्न लाइक व्हाट एवर इज लेफ्ट आउट। सो वी नीड टू लर्न अबाउट क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड, then blood groups, and there is a phenomena called as erythroblastus fetalis. I think you would have learned it. Yeah, so we will be just going through all those things today. That's it. With that, this chapter is done. So, completed 7 chapters. Okay. So first of all, when like I have to check. Yeah, I'm not the host, no.
Mom, she didn't join only.
She should enjoy. I've asked her to please make me the host. I shouldn't see the message. Ding, ding.
Today I joined at 10, 11:28.
Oh, that's very early. I thought you would be late, so I came late. Yeah. So first of all, clotting of blood. Okay, I'll tell you what the process is. So it's like a actually like a domino effect. Okay, it's like one after the other effect.
It'll
Okay.
fall.
Yeah, like one small cut is going to actually start so many processes. Okay, so the thing is that in our body we have like around 14 14 yeah 14 clotting factors. Okay, wow. So these factors are nothing but proteins, and they are going to help you in the process of clotting. And when this factor is absent, only that hemophilia happens.
Oh yeah, that I know, hemophilia.
Sorry, yeah. So what happens in the clotting of blood? So already the things that are required for clotting of blood is already there in our blood, but they all are in the inactive form. Okay, so they have to get activated whenever there is a
Plotting.
cut. Yeah, no, whenever there is a cut. Yeah. So how does this happen? So the first thing that happens is that
I'm your
whenever,
host now.
yeah, she said sorry, ma'am. Why is she saying sorry and all? Okay, so now I'll share the screen. Start now. Yes. So when you basically like your this one gets cut, no. So what happens is that the blood vessels are going to get cut, yes or no? Then only the blood will ooze out.
Mom, blood vessel get cut. Yeah, correct.
Yeah. So when the blood vessels get cut, so the blood vessel, the tissue outside the blood vessel is also damaged. Okay, as well as there will be platelets in the damaged vessels. Yes, you know that platelets are responsible for clotting of blood, yes or no? So whenever there is a cut anywhere, the platelets are like ambulance, they run to that place. Okay, so what will happen is that damaged tissue that is present outside the vessel, as well as the blood platelets that are present in the damaged vessel, both of these three two things will alert the clotting factors. Okay, now this clotting factors, what they do is that they will alert the next thing that is called as the prothrombin activator. So these clotting factors, what they will do is they will act as
So
prothrombin
when it's cut,
activator.
platelets are damaged. Platelets damage will signal the clotting factors. Clotting factors will activate the
Like clotting factors will become the prothrombin activator. So what is this prothrombin? Prothrombin is already present in your blood, okay? And it's basically in the inactive form. So it has to be converted to active form called as thrombin. So this prothrombin to thrombin conversion happens because of this prothrombin activator. Okay, and how does this prothrombin activator come into play? Because of the clotting factors. And how does this clotting factor come into the play?
Because of platelets damage.
Yes, because of the damaged tissue and the platelets. Yes. Now, once again. Yes. நான் இதுக்கு எஸ் அனுப்பணும் அவங்க ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கன்ஃபார்ம் பண்ணுறேன் அதுக்கப்புறம் பார்த்துக்கலாம் ஓகே ஸோ நவ் வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன் இஸ் திஸ் த்ரோம்பின் வில் கோ அண்ட் ஆக்டிவேட் சம்திங் கால்ட் அஸ் ஃபிப்ரினோஜன் Fibrinogen is in its inactive form. It has to become fibrin. Mm. So you have seen, no, after you get hurt, that brown color mesh-like structure.
Mm.
That mesh-like structure is nothing but your fibrin.
Oh, okay.
Okay, wow. So it is, you know, this entire clotting process is just like how you stitch. If you have some hole in your dress, you stitch, right?
Mm.
The thread that you use to stitch is fibrin.
Mm.
And who's helping you in stitching is the needle, and that needle is the prothrombin.
Prothrombin.
Okay. So what happens first step, as soon as you get cut, the platelets are rushing to that place, and then they will, along with the tissues, will give rise to the
As soon as we get hurt, tissue damage, because of this tissue damage, platelets are damaged. Those platelets will lead to the, will inform the clotting factor.
Mm.
The clotting factor will act as prothrombin activator, which will, which then prothrombin will be there.
That will convert the prothrombin to thrombin.
Thrombin. Then thrombin will convert the fibrinogen to this thing. What?
Fibrin. Fibrin.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so sorry. I told you, I'll get a call in between. I ordered on Swiggy, so.
Why, ma'am? So many steps are there in that Swiggy order, partner item option and all that.
Yeah, like they'll go, they'll first search for the item, then they'll click a picture and send, then you need to confirm it. And then
food or grocery, ma'am?
This is grocery only.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Yeah, you guys have Instamart. We don't have Instamart in Chennai.
I don't know what Instamart is.
Instamart is like instead of going like this and searching for the store, it's like Flipkart or Amazon directly available on Swiggy. You can just choose items from there.
Oh, yeah. We have that. Correct.
Yeah, yeah. So we don't have Instamart option, but we have an alternative option like this. Buy from the store.
Oh.
Okay. Now, yes. One more thing that you need to remember is that this prothrombin activator will work only in the presence of calcium ions.
Mm.
So calcium ions deficiency in the chinna, that person will have a difficult time in clotting of blood.
Mm.
This also you should remember.
Mm.
Okay, and what is the difference between fibrinogen and fibrin? Fibrinogen is soluble, whereas fibrin is insoluble.
Hmm.
This is the difference, okay?
Hmm.
So, you tell me the process once again.
Ma'am, when we get hurt, tissue and all is damaged.
Hmm.
Then from that, the platelets are damaged. No, because of that.
No, platelets are not damaged. The platelets will come to that place where it is damaged.
Oh, sorry. The platelets will act like ambulance.
Mm.
It will come to the place where we got hurt.
Mm.
It will then alert the clotting factor.
Mm.
Then clotting factor will act as prothrombin activator to convert prothrombin to thrombin.
Mm.
Then thrombin will convert soluble fibrinogen to insoluble fibrin.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, tell me the last part.
Ma'am, so the prothrombin activator will convert prothrombin to thrombin.
Okay.
Thrombin with the help of calcium ions will convert soluble fibrinogen to insoluble fibrin.
Fibrin. And this fibrin will go and form a mesh-like structure.
Yes, ma'am.
And then a fluid will ooze out of the, like once your, before it dries, no, when you get hurt, there will be like this white color fluid.
Yes, ma'am.
That white color fluid is called as serum.
Okay.
What is it called?
Serum.
Serum. Okay. Now, the thing is that you should know the difference between what is a serum and what is a plasma.
Ooh.
They both are not the same.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
They sound only different.
It is your plasma, if it does not have fibrinogen, then that portion is called as serum.
If plasma
does not have, see, plasma is a white fluid of the blood, no.
Mm.
That white fluid is going to contain all this fibrinogen and everything, correct?
Mm.
So if the, after clotting, the fibrinogen will not be there. That part of plasma where the fibrinogen is not there after clotting is called as serum.
Serum, okay.
Got it?
Serum.
Yeah, so technically it is a part of the blood only, blood serum. Okay. Mm. The thing is that only that plasma is going to ooze out. And which plasma is going to ooze out? The one without fibrinogen is going to ooze out.
The plasma without fibrinogen is serum.
Yes, correct.
Plasma with fibrinogen is?
Plasma.
Okay.
That's blood plasma.
Hmm.
Okay. Now, yes. So this is all about what we're going to talk about is antigen antibody. Okay. Any foreign substance to your body is antigen.
Mm.
Okay. And anything like that kills the antigen is called as the antibody.
Mm.
Okay. Who is in who's involved in this entire process? It is your lymphocytes.
Lymphocytes.
Yeah. I don't know why they didn't teach this thing. Are you okay? So listen, you can classify WBC into two types, okay?
Mm.
One is called as granulocytes, another is called as agranulocytes. Okay, granulocytes means they have these granules and granule-like structures, and agranulocytes means they don't have the granule-like granule-like structures. Okay, and that granulocyte can be further classified based on what type of stain they take.
Mm.
Okay, if it's acidic, acidophile, or eosinophils, that is your RBCs.
Mm.
Okay, then there is basophils.
WBC has granulocytes, agranulocytes.
Agranulocyte. Granulocyte can be classified as eosinophils. WBC lenge RBC vandhuche. Eosinophil, basophil, neutrophil.
Hmm.
Neutrophil means neutral dye it can take.
Hmm.
Okay, basophil means basic dye it will stain with.
Hmm.
And eosinophils means acidic dye it will stain with.
Mm.
Okay, then under agranulocytes will be the lymphocytes.
Okay.
And monocytes.
Mm.
Okay, monocytes will come under granulocyte. Let me just confirm with the monocytes. Is granulova or agranulova? That alone I'll confirm because I always get confused there. I don't want to teach you wrong. Monocytes which migrate to tissue macrophages. I'm so sorry. Lymphocytes is, as I said, is an agranulocyte, but the monocyte also comes under granulocytes, okay?
Ma'am. WBC. Granulo, agranulo. Granulo is lymphocytes.
Agranulo is lymphocytes.
Granulo is basophil, neutrophil.
Eosinophil. And also monocytes also come under granulocytes.
Okay.
Okay. But thing is that, see, how they function. Like when you talk about neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and all, they will release the histamine, serotonin, chemicals they will release, okay, mostly. But when you talk about monocytes, monocytes are macrophages.
which means what? They will macrophages are substances which are going to capture your foreign object. That is what is that process called? Phagocytosis, right? Yes. So monocytes generally work as a phagocytotic cell. Okay. So how does monocyte work is, so whenever there is any foreign object that has entered the body, these monocytes will move out of the capillary through the pore. Okay. And once they move out of the capillary, they will enlarge themselves in size. And monocyte will become macrophage.
Okay, ma'am.
What will it become? Processes. It's easy only. Monocyte is kutti. It has to grab something. No. So if it has to grab something, that means it has to become big in size, right?
Bigger. So it become macrophage.
Yes. And this process of the monocyte oozing out and it becoming big is called as diapedesis.
Oh, all this is there in PPT, ma'am.
No, this diapedesis and all is not there in PPT. That's why I'm explaining it to you again.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so WBC can be classified as granulocytes and?
Agranulocytes.
Agranulocytes. Under granulocytes, what all do you have?
Basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil.
Basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil. Other than that, what else you have?
Monocyte.
Monocyte. And then you have agranulocyte.
Lymphocytes.
Yes, and agranulocyte will become into?
Macrophages.
Macrophages. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
அப்படியே சொல்ல வேண்டியது. The monocyte will become into macrophage.
Yeah.
The question was asked based on this, like from what the macrophage is formed. It is formed from monocyte. Okay. That is only at the site where the foreign body is present. There, the monocyte will become into macrophage. What is the difference between monocyte and macrophage?
Monocyte is small.
Monocyte is small and macrophage is big. Okay. And then when you talk about lymphocytes, lymphocytes are of two types, which you must be knowing already. T lymphocyte, B lymphocyte.
T lymphocyte, differentiate and distinguish bone marrow, thymus.
Yeah. And then there is one more type of lymphocyte, which is called as a natural killer cell.
Oh yeah. T killer cell.
Yeah. Okay. So I hope this is clear for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This classification is important. That's why I'm teaching you again. Okay. Yes. These are the basics. I think you should you already know about.
Yeah, antigen key, this thing, binding.
Yeah. Now we'll talk about the blood groups.
Oh yeah. Blood group also we learned in Mendel.
Yeah. So basically when you talk about blood groups, each blood group on top of it will have a protein. Okay. And that protein is basically nothing but an antigen. Okay, so if my blood group is B, means I will have A antigen.
Yeah, if it is B, me, if it is A, no, ma'am.
If it is A, it will have A antigen.
A antigen. If it's B, it will have B antigen.
Yeah, correct. So why is it so? Is because if I have the B antigen, then my body will produce what antibodies? The one that is opposite.
For A.
Yes, for A. Okay.
So you will produce against yourself, so you'll die.
Yes, exactly. So that
is the fetalysis thing is also based on this, no?
Yeah, correct. So when we talk, let me go to the where is it? Yes. So when we talk about ABA and ABO, okay. So A will have A antigen, B will have
B. Ma'am, this I know. You ask me a question, I'll tell.
Yeah. So A will have A antigen.
A antigen, B but antibody of B. B will have B antigen, antibody of A. A, B will have A and B antigen, but no antibody.
Yeah.
Then that's O will have antibody for A, antibody for B, but no antigen.
The AB is universal what? Donor or acceptor?
Universal acceptor.
Why acceptor?
No. Universal donor.
Why donor?
Ma'am, because it has A and B antigen.
Oh, that is where you went wrong. See, it does not have antibody for body. A or B, no.
O is acceptor.
Acceptor because it does not have any
antigens.
O is donor. AB is acceptor.
First title correct only.
Yeah, then when I asked you, just changed it.
I panicked.
See, when there is no antibody in the body, then what will happen? Whatever blood you give to that particular person, it's not going to react.
Yeah, that's what.
So AB is an acceptor.
And I can give any blood because O is antigen. There is no antigen only.
There is no antigen. And again, O negative is the universal donor actually, not O positive.
Okay, ma'am.
That is a misconception everyone has, but O negative is a universal donor, okay? Mm. So this concept, though, you know, you can, whom you can give, whom you can't give and all. Yes. So yeah, there are few diseases which are like more like there are certain blood groups which are prone to certain diseases.
Mm.
Like for example, COVID-19, like blood group O people are like less susceptible, but the remaining people are more prone to the COVID.
Oh.
Yeah. Same way malaria, O is less susceptible.
Mm.
And people with blood group A are having like more chances of heart attack.
People with what, ma'am?
Blood group A.
Why, ma'am?
That is how the their blood composition is done. And they are more
but prone. It's not 100% necessary that they should get
it. No. It's not like if they have they will have. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Just give me a moment. I have to confirm this. Review. This is Chow Chow. Confirm. Don't even know. This is sweet corn. Yes. Confirm. Cauliflower. Yes.
And why is it so small?
No idea. Da. Sprouts in a different sprouts.
Mama, are all of those sprouts only?
In a different packet of sprouts, I can the green sprouts for them. Let me call him.
Ma'am, you review everything, ma'am. So once you can call.
The meaning is carrot only. That's not going to go wrong. So
imagine if that goes wrong.
How will carrot go wrong? Da? 3 pieces, confirm. Let me just call him up.
Paneer, all three together is 99, no?
No, 1 piece is 99.
Oh, that's what I was like, all three
99. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Yeah, he's worse than me, I think.
Bye, ma'am.
In shopping only. Okay. Yes. So now we come to RH grouping.
And people with B blood group have risk of what, ma'am?
B blood group generally doesn't seem to have any risk much.
So I'm
you're B negative or B positive?
B positive.
B positive
is the most common group available, I think. Everyone I know are B positive. But whenever I see B negative groups, no, I will always save their numbers and keep, because B negative is a rare group. Okay. Yeah, so now we come to the grouping. So when we talk about the grouping, if the RH factor is there, then it's RH positive. If it is not there, then it is RH negative.
Mm.
Okay. RH factor, the name RH came from the rhesus monkey because they discovered this factor in that monkey.
Mm.
Okay. So based on this, you have positive, negative.
Mm.
Okay. So like, it's not advisable that you be positive and negative. Yeah. So if the person is B positive and I am B negative, then I can't expect that person to you 8:32 ஒரு பச்சக்கறி வாங்குறதுக்கு இவ்வளவா Just a second, let me just complete this. Okay. Done. Okay, deliver. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So you didn't generally say that positive, like if you are positive, you can't donate like to a negative group. Nor if you are negative, you can receive, like you can give to a positive group. So either way, it is not possible.
If you are negative, you should give to negative only.
Yes. Yeah. So the same.
And if you are positive, you should receive from positive only.
Yeah, correct. Yeah. So the reason is because, again, that will also be considered as an antigen. So that will also, your body will react against it. So even the positive negative factor also has to be taken care of. Okay.
Yes,
that's the whole concept of erythroblastis fetalis.
Mm.
So wherein the first child will not get affected, but the second child will get affected. Okay, so how does that work? So that is why actually when you get married and all, they say that it's important to see the blood group matching. Okay, so even though scientifically and the Jadagam allah, they say no, in that they see all these things, but still it's better you ask the person what blood group they are, because that is going to affect the kid later on.
Mm.
Okay, so if the mother is having like all the negative rhesus factor and the kid is positive, so in the mother's body after the kid is born, the positive factor is going to remain there.
Ma'am, what can you repeat?
That is before, like during the pregnancy, okay, the mother does not have any, like mother is Rh negative.
Mm.
But the kid is Rh positive. Say mother is B negative and the kid is B positive.
Mm.
Okay. Then what will happen is after that baby has been delivered. Mm. Okay. So or the baby's blood is going to flow into the mother's bloodstream a bit during delivery.
Mm.
So that time these positive Rh factors are there, no, in the baby.
Mm. Mm.
That will come into the mother.
Mm.
So when the positive comes into a mother who has negative, definitely the body will start building antibodies. No.
Mm.
Antibodies against what it will build? Against the negative or positive it will build inside the mother's body?
Against the positive.
Positive, yes. Because positive is what is a foreign object, I mean foreign particle for the mother. Yes or no?
My mother is positive, baby is negative. So
yes.
When the negative blood of the negative reason.
No. Mother is negative.
Hmm.
Baby is positive.
So when the baby is positive, rhesus thing enters into the mother, it will fight against the negative. The negative will fight against the positive.
No. It will not fight and all. See, what will happen? No. In the mother's body, there will be antibody for positive.
Hmm.
Okay. Now, after some years, what is going to happen is that antibody is still going to be in the mother.
Hmm.
Okay, then what will happen when the mother gets conceived again?
Mm.
And again, if the baby is positive, there are antibodies, positive antibodies in the mother, no?
Mm.
That will act against the baby and kill the baby.
Mm. But if the baby is negative?
What?
If the second baby is negative?
No problem.
Okay.
The second baby is negative, no problem. So for this only, if this is the case, generally they give some injections and take care of it, okay?
So first baby means no problem.
Yeah, first baby, naladha vandu and the antibodies produce agudhu. Illana, avanga body la vandu Rh positive ka antibodies kadaiyadhu. Okay, wow, because she's completely negative, okay? She does not have any contact with the positive blood group until and unless she gets pregnant. And during the delivery, her blood gets mixed up with the baby's blood. That time only this happens.
Mm.
Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. As I said, they will give injections. Okay. They'll administer antibodies so as to prevent the death of this kid. Okay. Now, what is, answer this question. A person with AB blood group
lacks any antibodies on RBC surface.
Is it so?
Yeah, he doesn't have antibody A and B. No, he only has antigen. Correct, ma'am. ma'am, first option, second option, third option are correct.
Mm.
Fourth is wrong.
Lacks any antibodies on RBC surface. RBC surface la antibodies are irukko, antigen thana irukko.
So correct, no, he lack any antibodies on RBC surface only. No, that is correct, no.
Ah, yeah, it is correct. Then why the hell this is wrong? Hey, one second. Nani confused. Where is it? Ding, 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 ding. Where are you? A, B.
Antigens on RBC.
Antigens are on RBC. That is always there. Antibodies are not on RBC.
Antibodies are in plasma. But they are telling lacks. No, they are not telling it is there. They are telling lacks. First one is wrong, I get it. But second one can be correct, no?
Second one actually can be correct, yeah. I think then there is something wrong here. Okay, chuck it then. Okay, this I already explained to you. Remember the lymph thing I explained?
Ma'am?
How lymph is formed, I explained to you, remember?
Oh, it goes in the gap.
Fluid
goes in the gap in between those things.
Correct. So that only they have explained with diagram. I think this will be better for you to understand. Okay. So yeah, this is a capillary now. What will happen is there will be space.
That fluid will mix with this plasma to form lymph.
Correct. Fluid. So what will happen is that certain substances like what all? Water, dissolved substances and WBC. These will go out of the capillary. Okay. And they will go into the interstitial fluid. That means between the tissues.
Between tissues.
Yes. And there, as I said, there will be what vessel?
Lymph vessel.
Yes. Which will collect the fluid, and that fluid is called as?
Lymph fluid.
So lymph will consist of what all?
WBC. Water.
Water here basically means plasma, okay? Plasma consists of water and proteins. So that will be there here. Then?
It consists of WBC, proteins, ions, and then that's all.
Nutrient hormones also.
Oh, okay. Nutrient hormone.
I told you, hormones are also carried by lymph. Okay, certain hormones are, okay. Then this entire lymph vessel together will form the what system? Lymphatic system.
Lymphatic system.
Yes. And yes, these things all we have learnt already. About like in the digestion chapter, we learnt about lacteal. You remember?
Lacteal. Yes, ma'am. In digestion chapter, I think.
Yeah.
It is that this thing, no?
Some fats basically enter into this lymphatic vessel called as lacteal. Because they are bigger in size. So they don't enter into the blood vessel. They enter into the lacteal.
They are present in some in intestine.
Yes, in the intestine villi. Okay. Lymph is colorless because
hemoglobin is absent.
Correct. That's it. So with that, we are done with this chapter.
What a proud moment it's
chapter.
Been.
It's an easy chapter, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So I just wanted to complete this chapter.
Come next, which thing we are starting?
The next one. Which is the next one? I think excretory is the next one. No.
We'll finish off entire physiology.
Yeah, yeah. After excretory, there is LAM, and then there is NCC, and there is chemical coordination. That's it. Three more chapters, we are done with human physiology.
Then we can do plant physiology.
We can do that. Anyway,
we'll finish off this more theory, because in first half of the book, if you see, there is only kingdom, like all main information just to mug up and write.
Yeah, but that also you need to know what all to study extra also, no?
Oh, yes. Ma'am, but they're telling no need to study extra only.
No, you can't predict the...
There was a rule that was passed only NCERT, no? After removal of AIIMS and JIPMER exam.
Yeah, that is there. But again...
Even in last year 2020 NEET paper, if you see, everything was only from NCERT.
That is there. But again, you might never know what...
they are, might ask or they might change the rule. They keep changing and evolving. Okay. So we need to be ready. So at least not very much extra, like how you prepare for AIIMS or JIPMER, but you should at least
I asked one teacher from Akash because they give those books, right, for NEET.
Yeah.
So even in their books, he was telling that they only included NCERT. Like usually they have the gray shaded part, no, only for NEET and JEE in their books. If you see in NCERT part will be normal, that gray and shaded extra information will be for NEET. But then now that is also, they removed it off. It's only like NEET this thing, but only from NCERT, even he was telling.
Yeah, yeah. I like what I'm trying to tell you is that if there is any concept in NCERT, okay, it is not like they'll ask you that directly. There are chances that they'll might ask you a little bit extra from that. And they can say that it's already there in the textbook. Okay. See, for example, monocyte is something that is there in the textbook. Okay. Now they can, and macrophages is also there in the textbook, but the relation between them, the monocyte to macrophage, is not clearly explained. Now, if I don't explain to you and they ask a question based on that, it was asked in previous year NEET, okay, what will you do? That is what, so when I say extra, I'm not talking about learning a lot, like how you
like how far before they used to learn. No,
exactly, not like that. Whatever is there in a textbook, if because NCERT is a thing which gives you like just words, okay. But they don't explain the process. So if I just tell you lymph, so you're going to just mug up what is lymph. But now that you know how lymph has formed, you can at least understand the concept of the lymphatic vessels and everything. No.
So if they ask any application question, I'll get it.
Yeah, application question, you will understand it. You can answer it in a better way. Okay, that is the reason why I keep telling extras needed. Okay, and I'm not someone who loads like lumber extra information. It'll help you on the longer run also.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, like you can all some information you can sometimes might be helpful in your board exam for writing some answers also. Yeah. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll end today's class. We'll meet up tomorrow and then we'll do the questions.
Ma'am, tomorrow I'm not sure, ma'am, this time.
What happened?
My school might extend till like 1:30 and then 1 anyways have class.
Okay, then no
I'll problem. Tell you tonight only, like by evening I'll tell you.
Yeah, not an issue. I can also take it on Wednesday.
Wednesday for sure. Wednesday afternoon. Friday afternoon also for sure.
Okay, cool. Then I can take it on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Tomorrow even I was thinking of cancelling it. So
okay, ma'am.
We can have it on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday itself.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Bye-bye.